نستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهول به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا، واجعله الوارث منا، واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، وانصرنا اللهم على من عادانا، ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا. اللهم ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا يا رب العالمين. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم، إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم، يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت، وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها، وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. وصلي وسلم على مبعوث رحمة العالمين سيدنا محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه، وعنا معهم إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most compassionate, the most merciful, all praise and thanks are due to him, and peace and blessings be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He who is guided by the will of Allah, no one can misguide him, and he who is misguided, no one can guide him except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger. Respected brothers and sisters in Iman, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today's khutbah with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be about Islamic bargains or divine bargains we might not be aware of. Safaqat murbiha, Islamiyya wa ilahiyya. Within our Islam, there is a great bargains that are offered to many of us, some of us might not be aware of. So it could be, inshallah, an opportunity between you and me, inshallah. Allah might be using me
help my brothers and sisters just to reschedule their life on the base of bargaining, just to get much more than you might be expecting in terms of ajr. Now, in the introduction, let me just highlight the following. I think none of us, I mean practicing Muslims, but our first aim in our life is to seek the satisfaction of Allah and to be from the people of the Jannah. I think this is something agreed upon between all of us. None of us, but this is his or her ultimate goal in life. Jannah, satisfaction of Allah. Everything else comes as a marginal issue. This is the ultimate goal for all of us. Now, we know, but it just to remind myself and my respected brothers and sisters, that the main gate or the basic pillar to get into Jannah is Iman, with the pillars of Iman, faith. Then, al-amal bi-muqtada al-Iman, to work accordingly, which is Arkan al-Islam, the pillars of Islam, to gain faith and to work upon your faith. The one that you believe in is commanding you to do, to stop doing, or X, Y, Z, etc. This is, in brief, basically the Iman. Now, we need to know as well that even though if we conclude ourselves or consider ourselves practicing Muslims, even though we are doing our best to gain the ajr, still we have this kind of risk or this kind of being nervous and afraid, because we have ups and downs. All of us, including myself, all of us, we do face some kind of laziness sometimes. We do commit sometimes major sins or minor sins. None of us is an angel. None of us. So yes, we are struggling, inshallah, in the sake of Allah. But however, still, we are facing a lot of defects in our life. Now, in light of this introduction, I'm standing here to tell you about bargains. You know, the bargain is the very successful, deal. when you call something a bargain, it's not just any deal. The bargain is the excellent deal. Exceptional deal. So let's all together have an idea about, while I'm in the path, in the way of reaching to Allah, every day passes, practically we are closer to Allah's step. That's why a pause outside of everything I'm saying, just a small pause. I always can't understand the one who celebrates his birthday if he is not close to Allah. I can't understand he's celebrating what? I repeat, I'm not discussing the hukum of celebrating birthday now. It's not my point. I wonder if anyone feels happy with having his birthday celebration if he does not pray, for example, if she's not wearing the hijab. Celebration of birthday means I have finished another year to grave. It means what? I was 50, now I'm 51. So I used to have just last 5 years of my life, now I have 4. Next birthday celebration, I have just 3 years to grave. Next celebration, I have just 2 years to grave. I'm not discussing this is acceptable, celebrate whatever you want. My point, anyone who celebrates a birthday while being far from Allah, does not care about meeting Allah, how come they feel happy when celebrating a closeness to death? This is my own feelings. I'm just highlighting this in this context. So because all of us, we have this kind of fear. So in light of this, I will want to share with you a very, very beautiful, let's say, glad tidings about bargains. Bargains, how to make benefit from a very little effort with the highest possibility of ajr and rewards. And why not? If this is part of our faith. I will be highlighting 3 or 5, depending on the time, out of similarities of tens like this type. So just to connect you with the concept, then be clever enough how to reschedule your life on how to make benefit of the divine bargains. صفقات الإلهية الرابحة, which are spread. Number one, for example, من صلى الصبح في جماعة فهو في ذمة الله. حديث صحيح.
I repeat.
The one who prays the Fajr as a jama'ah, he is in Dhimmatullah. Dhimmatullah means the protection of Allah. The safety that comes from Allah. The shield, the guarantee of protection. Now, one of the daily basis bargains, if you want to be happy in case this day is the last day of yours, just make sure from a criterion, pray the jama'ah fajr. Let this be part of your competition with yourself, just to the best of your knowledge, to be in the safe side. One bargain, pray jama'ah fajr jama'ah, at home or at the masjid, the best at the masjid. At home for whatever reason, but jama'ah is great. The least, there's another hadith sahih, man salla al-fajra, without mentioning the jama'ah, fahu fi dhimmatillah. Just the fact, because the most difficult one, fajr means I'm fighting my desire, I'm fighting my need, you know, getting to the fajr after sleeping just 2 or 3 hours late, all of us, we would love just to keep our heads on the pillow. And when the alarms come, it's the most beautiful time for your sleep, subhanAllah. The most beautiful. You see this kind of inner discussion, you want to leave, others, you know, still I have 15 minutes, why not to enjoy it? I'm very tired, Allah knows that. Then we lose. The fighting for the sake of Allah, believing that this Fajr prayer is a compulsory by Allah in itself, it's a guarantee. So I'm giving you just one divine bargain that can you can keep using it on daily basis to compete with yourself and to know in your schedule of am I close or far from Allah, close or far, close from Allah. One of the bargains, Fajr, on time, the minimum. More, jama'ah at home. The best, jama'ah at the masjid. So, one of the great bargains. Why? Fi dhimmatillah. Full protection up to the end of that day. Alhamdulillah. Next day, renew and recharge your account with another new protection. As if, in my own words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us like insurance that will cover you completely for 24 hours. The one who takes this insurance is you. You need to press a button. By this, you are in. You are insured. If you do not press it, you are not insured. The one who decides whether you will be insured or not is yourself, myself. So it's up to me. This is one of the divine bargains. Dhimmatullah, protection of Allah, safety of Allah, backing of Allah, love of Allah, by your decision. One, number one bargain. Number two. Prophet Muhammad in hadith sahih قال من قرأ آية الكرسي دبر كل صلاة لم يكن بينه وبين دخول الجنة إلا أن يموت. The one who keeps on reciting آيات الكرسي. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. If you kept reading this ayah after every time you finish your compulsory prayer, the only reason that will prevent you from being in the Jannah is to die. Which means if you die at any moment, you are from the people of the Jannah. Hadith sahih. Yeah. Some people they say, come on, Shaykh, this is so easy. Islam is not so silly in this way. By the way, test yourself and see if you can do it. It's not easy, by the way. Wallah, it's not easy. You know why? Because believing in that means you'd have full trust that Allah will give you this. Which means Allah, you will be mindful, you yourself, you must be mindful of Allah, having the taqwa of Allah, the hub of Allah, the love of Allah, the respect of Allah all the time. And you will respect the time of the prayer and you will be aware in advance that you will do this with the intention of being in the Jannah if you pass away. Which means you will remember death exactly with every salah. The one who remembers death 5 times and he recites Ayat al-Kursi with the intention of being protected to be from the Jannah. If I die, definitely his life will be in a straight path. Or otherwise, by the way, remembering this is not a philosophy. Doing this, it's not just a theoretical philosophy. It's part of a practical action and a will structured plan on daily basis. And by the way, at the end, it's your choice and my choice. Try, by the way, taking a decision that you want to recite with this intention will push you to fix everything before. This is like an indirect way, another pose. Like when we tell the sisters that whether you loved or not, hijab is a compulsory from Allah. But if you want to see part of the wisdom behind the hijab, when you have it, by default, you will hesitate to commit many bad things because you are wearing the hijab. In itself, it's a well-structured generator to protect yourself even if you want to do something bad or just to whatever. Because no one knows me. No, you are well known now. You are a Muslim with the hijab. So you will, like the Sheikh, for example, when you are known that a practicing Muslim with your lihya, with your beard or something, even if you want to make a bad joke or to do something bad, you will count to 10 because you know that the people are watching you, which is part of the good thing. It's not a bad thing. But I'm just giving an idea about, some people might think this hadith sahih, reciting ayat al-kursi after the day. Is it Islam so easy? From one angle, easy. Easy if you decided and I decided to let everything in my life be according to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is one of the glad tidings. If you kept on doing that every time and time, this is a good news from Allah to you that you are on the right track. This is another bargain. So number one, we knew Man Salla al-Sabha, the one who prays the Fajr. The second one is Man Qara'a Ayat al-Kursi. Now the third one. Imam al-Bukhari and Imam Muslim, both of them, they narrated, which is when we say Bukhari and Muslim, they call it in our Islamic terminology muttafaq alayh, in the highest level of authenticity. They narrated an Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is an amazing one. By the way, this, wallahi, it's amazing. قال من قال لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. Just this, how many words? لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. 15 words, which takes less than 10 seconds. قال the one who said لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير في يوم 100 مرة 100 times every day just 100 times كانت له. Now the reward of saying this 100 times, which might take about 15 minutes 12 to 15 minutes, just say it with the span of the whole day, highly preferable to be said at the very early morning if you said it according to the Bukhari or Muslim. Abu Hurairah is telling us what Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. If you do it, قال كانت له. Now count with me. كانت له عدل عشر رقاب. It, you will gain the ajr as if you have freed from slavery 10 persons. Can you imagine when you free a slave in Islam, everything, every khayr this person will do as a free person will be, you will take a couple from his ajr. As if you have freed 10 persons from slavery. Number one. قال كانت له عدل عشر رقاب وكتب له مئة حسنة. In addition, you will have 100 rewards. ومحيت عنه مئة سيئة. 100 sins of the previous sins will be deleted from your account of what you have done. Number four. وكانت له حرزا من الشيطان. And it will be a shield or protection from the shaitan, his whispering, you know, to overcome you. قال يومه ذلك حتى يمسي. Now, saying this 100 times, which is around 10 to 12 minutes, and you can say it 50-50 or 10-10-10 with each time. Anyway, up to the end of that day, you will have all of these great things. 100 hasana, 100 sayya will be deleted, as if you have freed 10 people from slavery, full protection from the shaitan, providing that you believe in that and you do it out of respect, like what we said. This is another bargain. Imagine, by the way, you might think it's easy. Wallahi, it's not easy. We think, because I will give you like a proof that even though these things seem to be very simple, they are not simple. Just let's ask ourselves, how many of us, we do our best not to lose the sunnah after the fard every time, all the day. How many times? Sometimes you just say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Someone is ringing. Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah, notification. You lick, you start with the WhatsApp, khalas.
Someone will call you, someone will shake hands with you. You are in a hurry, you will catch the GO train, you will catch the bus, you will catch the whatever, the Zoom meeting, the project, all the time you are busy. Most of us, including myself, we do intentionally lose this kind of sunnah because simply they are not compulsory. Practically, all of us, we are busy. Regardless, we are busy in good, genuine things or silly things, but we are busy. So don't think the challenge is easy to say it 100 times. But if you insisted to do it, you have provided for yourself in your account that really you believe in that. And by the way, just to try it. Try to challenge yourself by saying, Ya Allah, I want to challenge myself to do it just for 1 week to see what kind of impact this will make in my life. Just do it. If you can do it after the Fajr, the best. Just to stay. After you do the Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, normal things that you know, just isolate yourself 10 minutes, say, La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah lahul mulk wa lahul hamd. ويحيي من يميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير 100 times and see what will happen to you and then take the decision. This is three different bargains. Now another one, another bargain which is very beautiful. The hadith is very well known. You choose from this hadith which category you would love to be from. By the way, when reciting this hadith, I feel as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most wise, the all wise, al-hakim, he made Islam for us like a big market. You just go and choose which item you would love to take. But you need to know that each item has its own price. And we all have a credit card full divinely with the money. The money now is your intention and your effort. You just take a decision, make an effort, choose. So you can, that's why, you know, we have many gates to get into the Jannah. We have the gate of As-Sa'imin. We have the gate of Al-Mutasaddiqeen. It's not necessarily you to be the best in Qiyam al-Layl. Maybe you can't. The nature of your work is very hard. Allah knows that. Okay. Maybe you have the gate of fixing the relations of the people. You have no problem to fast for the sake of Allah. Someone else, he's working very hard in the construction. He can't fast. If he does not eat, he can't work. But he can donate. He's earning $500 a day. Better than 5 professors at the university. Very tough working. May Allah give him barakah in his time. Can he donate? Yalla. This is another. This person decided to get into the Jannah from this gate. The other one decided from this gate. This is how I see the greatness of Islam. We are not supposed to do everything. There are different gates, but you take a decision. The decision must be taken that I must be from the people of the Jannah. This is the decision. Now choose which is closer to your heart, which one makes you more happy. It's up to you. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us different options. Look to this great hadith, Sahih hadith, which you all know. سَبْعَةٌ ظِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّ. You know, 7 categories of people at the day, you know, this is a metaphor. They will be protected by the shade of Allah, which means they have a special status of a protection and tranquility when we are gathered Yawm al-Qiyamah. You know, the most difficult day in our life is Yawm al-Hashr and Yawm al-Hisab, the day of accountability. When we will be brought from death into life again, resurrection and congregation, al-jam'a wa-hashr wa-nushur, and the accountability. We will be waiting for the accountability to start. We will be billions and billions, Allah knows, Allah, trillions, tens of billions, hundreds of billions, tens of trillions, Allah knows. Because we don't know when Adam alayhi salam was created. 100,000 years, 200, half a million, we have no idea. But we can assume that we are tens of billions. Tens of billions will be gathered. 7 categories will be protected with this. وَلِلَّهِ مَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. Just to give you an idea at the day of judgment will happen. وَلِلَّهِ مَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. Just to make it simple. Imagine yourself, you will attend a very important event, which is so serious, very important, and you must go there.
However, you are waiting in the line outside and thousands of people are waiting. If you could be from those who are waiting online, but VIP. Special protection, special chairs, a lot of drinks, hot, soft, but you are waiting your turn. But you are waiting in a very comfortable situation. Others just waiting, sweating, afraid, no one speaks with them. Others, VIPs. In the day of judgment, Allah has His own VIPs. VIPs are under seven categories. Now let's highlight the seven categories very, very quickly. Take a decision now to be one of them. One of them, you will be protected, which means you will be from the people of the Jannah. Now, the first one, قال إمام عادل. This is just a dream now in the Arab world. So let's not discuss it because we don't have it, alhamdulillah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, a just, fair ruler. I don't know if you heard about him. I personally don't know anyone. So let's forget it. None of us will be a ruler. We're just normal Muslims, alhamdulillah. So number one, forget it. Now let's go to two, from two to seven. قال إمام عادل وشاب نشأ في عبادة الله. A young man, he was raised under the respect of the commandments of Allah. Is that so complicated? Because if you are a young man, means your desire are much more stronger. Means the challenge is 10 times than the old person. Okay? Are you facing challenges? Yes. The fact that you have hot shorts outside? Yes. The fact wherever you go, porno things in you? Yes, yes, yes. It's up to you. You want to be from those? Fight all these kinds of haram desires. Very simple. If you don't want, I'm telling you, this is one of the categories. You would like to be from them? Number one. طيب. Another one. قال ورجل قلبه معلق بالمساجد. A man, and by the way, in Arabic language, using the word رجل means a person. Does not mean just a male. It means a male and a female. Okay? قال ورجل قلبه معلق بالمساجد. His, metaphorically, in Arabic, his heart is highly connected with the masjid, which means his priority, Salat al-Jama'ah, his priority is to have his word, to come before the prayer, to do his word, to write the Quran, to read the Quran, to listen to the Durus al-Ilm, whatever. But now his priority in his life is the masjid. Some people, they say, but I can't. Okay, I'm not pushing you to be from those. I'm telling you, this is one of the categories. Do we have now Muslim retired people? Do we or we don't? Definitely, like any other groups on earth, we have retired people. Is it true that many retired people, they have enough money to keep having their living expenses up to death or not? They have worked hard the last 40 years of their life. They have savings with hundreds of thousands or millions. What prevents those people from being from this category? Simple question. If they take a decision, nothing stops them. It's a decision. But I'm just giving you the glad tidings that this is one of the categories. Another category. قال ورجلان تحابا في الله اجتمعا عليه وتفرقا عليه. Two persons, they loved each other for the sake of Allah, which means no kind of hidden interest just because I want something, but no, for the sake of Allah, because he loves Allah, because he's close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask about him, I do good for him, he does good for me, the same thing. Just imagine, you love someone for the sake of Allah. You might be from the category of being protected in the day of judgment, waiting for your accountability. Some people, they say, subhanAllah, it's very easy. Wallah, it's not easy. Let's go and review our relations, on what basis we have our connections. Let's be frank. On what basis? Flan narateeku, flan marhubbo, flan, I have to speak with him because at the end he's my boss, you know. The other one is my relative, the other one I don't want to cause troubles, but really I hate even the, you know, the ground that he's stepping on. Yet, many of our relations, depending on social, hypocritical aspects, in many cases. So it's not easy. So let's review our relations, one of the categories. Next category. قال ورجل دعته امرأة ذات منصب وجمال فقال إني أخاف الله. Someone was exposed to commit the haram, the zina. It's not just the zina, no. You know, the influence of a woman against the man is 10 times than the other way around. This is how Allah created us. So when a woman is presenting herself for a man to do the haram, and she is very beautiful with high position or high status socially or whatever, it's one of the examples when the haram has come to you into your doorstep. You have not done any efforts. And it's really, the desire is very strong. When you stop this for the sake of Allah, you will be another small copy of Yusuf alayhi salam. You will be in the category of Yusuf alayhi salam. So, but by the way, some people will say, yeah, Sheikh, do you think it happens? Well, it happens with some people. Everyone knows himself. It happens with some people. It's not always the men they do, they just keep chasing. No, sometimes it's the opposite. Everyone, but this is one of the categories. Now, ورجلون, and let's come to the last two things which could be applicable on every single person of us by the easiest way. The last two categories. قال ورجلون تصدق بصدقة فأخفاها حتى لا تعلم شماله ما أنفقت يمينه. This is a metaphor. It's a stylish, rhetorical, Arabic style, you know, metaphoric with exaggeration. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says, a man that used to do donations, sadaqah, he used to do it secretly, not to show off, to a degree that his left hand does not know what his right hand is doing. Practically, you know, it's not a literal, but it means he was so really pure in his heart, and intention was really for the sake of Allah. And really, he was doing his best not to let anyone know this sadaqah. He was not taking just Instagram or TikTok while you make a sadaqah to this poor man. Make dua for me. You know, this is, I don't know what do they, what's in their heads when they do something like that. And by the way, some people, they do it. Some people on the social media, they do it. But for example, to a degree, as if the hand, which normally we use our right hand to give the sadaqah, I was really honest to a degree, my even this hand did not know that I was paying the money with this. It's a metaphor to give you really how genuine and honest you were. By the way, can all of us be from this category or not? Wallahi, we can. By the way, nothing stops you. And you speak about sadaqah, we are not discussing amount of money. Sadaqah could be with $1 for the sake of Allah. And by the way, you can be from the mutasaddiqin on a daily basis with $1. Khalas, you have, this is your ability. $1 a day, no problem. Do $1 a day. $5, $5 a day. Which is less than a falafel or shawarma sandwich, basically. Less. You can't eat falafel and shawarma now with $5. Most of us, we can pay $5 just to be accounted from the mutasaddiqin every day. With this intention, no one knows, for example. And the last one, قَالْ وَرَجُلُ ذَكَرَ اللَّهُ خَالِيًا. قال رجل ذكر الله خاليا ففاضت عيناه. In another hadith, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says, the last one of the categories, قال من بنى مسجدا لله بنى الله له مثله في الجنة. Anyone who builds a masjid, which includes you will be sharing the ajr, even if you were participating in building a masjid for the sake of Allah, you will be having a house in the Jannah, or you are participating in part of the house of the Jannah. Any one of us can do this. Anyway, as I told you, respected brothers and sisters, that I finished my khutbah by this. Now, all of us, we know that we are facing very difficult times, generally speaking, politically, economically, and many of us, we might die at any moment. قلت بها واستغفر الله لي ولكم فيفوز المستغفرين. إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. اللهم ارحمنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويومنا عرض عليك يا كريم. اللهم إنا عبيدك أبناء عبيدك أبناء إمائك موصين بيدك ماض فينا حكمك عدل فينا قضاؤك. نسألك بكل اسم ولك سميت به نفسك وأنزلته في كتابك وعلمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك أن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا وجلاء أحزاننا وذهاب همومنا وغمومنا يا رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة.